In this tutorial, we're going to go through the WordPress dashboard. The dashboard is what you'll arrive at once you log in. The dashboard will show you everything that's been happening in your website since you last logged in. The area you want to pay most attention to is in this top left-hand corner. Under content, we'll give you a list of how many posts, pages, categories and tags you have. Under discussion, this will tell you how many comments you have, how many of them have been approved, how many comments you have pending, and how many comments you have in spam. What we'll do now is we'll go through the left-hand menu, which will give you all options you need to edit and manage your website. First item is Home, which you can click on whenever you are to take you back to the dashboard. The next is Updates. If there are any WordPress software updates or plugin updates, these will be listed here as well as all the instructions you need to get them updated. If you have a Kismet installed, your statistics will be shown here. Kismet is a very, very good plugin to have to stop comments that are spam arriving on your website. Now, under the next main section is Posts. If you see there's a little down arrow right next to the main sections, just click on the down arrow to expand those options. Now under Posts, if you click on All Posts, you'll see a list of all the posts that you have created and are published in your website, including drafts. If you want to add a new post, you can click on Add New in the left-hand menu. And this will give you a blank form to fill in to add a new post. The next item down is categories. Categories are a way to organize and manage all your posts under different titles or sections on your website. Post tags is the next item down, and this is a way to mark each post and tell people what that post is about. Now under media is where all your photos and media files such as video and sound clips are kept. If you click on Library, you'll get a list of all the items you have currently in your library. You can view all, you can view just images, or if you have music or sound, audio or video clips here, there'll be an option here for you to just view these. So at any time that you need to use a photo or other media in your blog post or pages, they'll be found in your library. Now, if you want to add new items to your library, you can click Add New in your left-hand menu and follow the instructions. The next section down is Links. Again, click on the down arrow to open up your options. You can click on All Links. This gives you a list of all the links that you have on your website that you're storing for future use. You can click Add New to add a new link. And you can also create categories for your links, which is a great way to organize your links if you have quite a few. The next section down we have Pages. Again, click on the down arrow to expand your options. And you can click on All Pages to see a list of all the pages you have on your website. You can choose to view all, only the ones that are published, or only the ones you have in draft. If you want to create a new page, you can click Add New in the left-hand menu, and this will give you a blank form to fill in for a new page. Under Comments, this will give you a list of all the comments that you have on your website. It will give you the option to view all, or pending for approval, or your approved comments, any comments that have been marked as spam, and any comments that have been marked as trash. The next section is Appearance. Under Appearance, you can choose to change many different features of your website to change the look and style. The first option is Themes, and this will show you the current theme you have selected on your website. Any new themes will be uploaded to this area, and you can choose to select a new theme to change to. Widgets is the next item. Widgets are a very useful way to extend the usability of your website, giving it different features and adding things to the sidebar, adding things to the footer or the header, depending on the theme of your site. Menus is a recent feature of WordPress version 3, where you can create your own menus, you can reorganize your menus and have drop-down elements as well, and you can have menus in the header, the footer, or in the main sections of your website, depending on your theme. The next item is background. Now you can choose to have an image in the background of your website, or none at all, or just a color. This gives you a bit of styling change. The next option down is usually your theme options. As you can see here, I have a theme called Aggregate, and in here I have a panel of many, many options that I can use to change the look and style of my website. This will be dependent on your choice of theme. The next element down is Editor, and this is an area where you can change, or your web developer can change, the look and style of your website. It's best not to make any changes to this site unless you're absolutely comfortable with CSS and PHP. The next section we'll look at is plugins. Plugins are little pieces of software that can be added to your website to add functionality to it. For example, a spam filter, social media interactivity, sitemaps, and many, many more things. We'll go into plugins in a later video. If you'd like to add a new plugin, you can click Add New in the left menu and either search or upload your plugin to be installed. Again, your editor is an area that should only be edited if you're familiar with PHP. And sometimes you'll find other options in your plugins list. For example, I have a Kismet configuration here, which gives me options to change my configuration for that particular plugin. The next section down is Users. You can view all the users on your website. Now, a user is either yourself as the administrator or other people you've given the ability to log in and make changes on your behalf. You can create a new user here by Add New and enter all the information here to allow someone else to log in under their own username and password. Your profile is where you can change information about yourself, your email address, that information from your website goes to, and also a few biographical snippets of information should you wish to include that. The next section down is tools. Tools will show you any available tools that have been installed with your current version of WordPress, and we'll go into this in later videos. If you need to import any information, such as a database or a different version of your website, you can import it under the tools section here. Export is where you can export your database or your posts and pages into a file that you can store on your computer. And this is a great way to back up your website. Now, under settings, this is the nuts and bolts of your website where you can edit information to suit your style and feel of the website. Under general is things like the name of your website, your website URL or address, email addresses, date format, and things like that. Writing controls how you want to write to the blog, specifications on your blog posts, and update services as well. Reading controls how you want your posts to be displayed on your website. Discussion is about how you want people to communicate with you on your website. In other words, comments and how you would like to control them. Media gives you settings on the size of your images and also where on your WordPress site you would like to store all your media files. Privacy is the next one. You can choose to have your site visible to everyone, including the search engines, or you can block search engines. You would do this if you were developing your site and you weren't yet ready for visitors to your website. Permalinks is a topic we'll go into more detail in an advanced video of WordPress. By default, WordPress will handle the permalinks of your posts and pages automatically, and you don't need to worry about this. A permalink is the URL of each page and each post of your website. Depending on the plugins that you have installed on your website, you may have other options available to you, such as Google Analytics, or Twitter or other social media. Now we'll go back to the dashboard. And that is your dashboard tour of WordPress.